Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Planescape Torment Blind. Yes, I'm the RPG chick. We failed miserably last time. What I did is I restored from a previous save from before I went in here and got a whole bunch of crap. Gave him this, the Ring of Fallen Stars. Ended up buying Cloud Kill. We've got all Cloud Kill. And this invokes Cloud Kill. In case he gets interrupted while casting the spell, he won't get interrupted while casting this. So that's to use against those shadows. I got a whole bunch of heart charms, 35 now, and Adder's Tear, you know, which could be good too. What I did is I got this. I bought up everything from Vris Chica's Curiosity Shoppy. So I found that in there, and I guess I do know what it is. I'm gonna identify that. Somebody asked if we have this, and yes, we have this. And yes, we have that. The answer to your question. That invokes Cold Lightning. It's always good too. We got extra stuff. Cone of Cold, Celestial Host. Yeah, I do want to try that out. So I can't even copy this spell because it's level 9 and we're nowhere near that level, unfortunately. But we can use it once as a scroll. Okay, this thing. This tiny pebble looks like it was chipped from a larger piece. The edges of it are jagged like teeth, and the texture of it makes the small stone seem more like a withered seed than a stone. It has a faint reddish color about it, as if it was once stained with blood. Identify. This is the Eye of Vecna, which is pretty famous in D&D world. No, we're not going to be using this, but I'm going to read the description, which is quite lengthy. It is cursed. It doubles all your first and second level mage spells, which is great. 35% resistance to magic, plus 4 on your saves versus death magic, which is good too, but minus 3 to wisdom and intelligence. So we're not going to be using that. I don't think it's going to be that. We're not going to be even using first and second level mage spells that much. In the end game here, as such as it is. So anyway, many tales are told of the Arch-Lich Vecna. What would it be? Arch-Lich. It is said that Vecna was one of the plane's mightiest sorcerers, able to draw life from dust and send it back again, extinguish lives with a glance, and make the earth shudder beneath his touch. He was said to be so powerful that when the end of his life drew near, death refused to take him into its kingdom. And so Vecna died, yet lived on. Abandoned by death, Vecna became the master of a vast kingdom on a prime world called Earth? Orth? Orth? I call it Earth. Neither kind nor just, Lord Vecna's rule was one of great horror and suffering, and it is said that his reach was so great that even the powers of Earth feared to cross him for fear of drawing his eye. Yet while Vecna's gaze traveled ever outward in search of new conquest, he failed to see his own end when it came for him, in the form of his lieutenant Kaz. As was fitting for Vecna's left-hand servant, the Arch-Lich had fashioned a terrible weapon for his lieutenant as a symbol of his authority. Vecna made this weapon with such skill, it is said that part of the sorcerer entered the blade, and it was this sliver of Vecna that gave the blade its life and its treacherous nature. Where once there was lifeless steel, there became thought, intent, and perhaps most horrible of all, a voice. The sword whispered treacheries to the ambitious Kaz, night upon night, month upon month, year upon year, until one night, the remains of Kaz's discipline was seduced by the rippling edge of the blade. Convinced by his blade that he was Vecna's superior, Kaz confronted his dread master upon his desiccated throne, and the two of them fought a terrible battle. During the battle, Kaz was killed, but before he fell, His blade had dismembered his former master, scattering his remains so that no one may draw them together again. And so it has come to pass that pieces of Vecna have made their way across the plains. One of these is the Eye of Vecna. I need a drink here. It carries with it a bloody, violent history, so much so that many scholars refuse to speak of its treacheries for fear the Eye will come to them, seeking to add another victim to its bloody chronology. The Eye of Vecna was instrumental in the extermination of the House of Hierek, once the ruling dynasty in Nirand. It is said to have been behind the sundering of the conclave of Tisis on the sea, which led to the three-cycle war that poisoned the seas of Malatai and left the oceanic world barren of life. On the ashen plain of Galentir, it possessed the gentle father of Sassaran, a babe with the potential to lead his suffering people from their shadowed lands to the gates of paradise. Had not the Eye drove Sassaran's father to murder his son as he lay sleeping in his crib. All these kingdoms, all these futures, the Eye of Vecna laid waste. The Eye's powers are said to shift with each new owner, but one thing is certain, no good ever comes to whoever has the misfortune to possess it. It is destined to betray its wearer at a critical moment, failing him when he needs its power the most. Not a good thing. I don't think that's something we want to have happen. So, still, it was an interesting story, and I don't think we're going to need any of the money anymore. I'm not sure when we had that or whatever. Alright. So, there's another area behind us which we have to go to.
This is it.
This is it, right. So I noticed it on my playback. There's an area up around here.
Great power is here.
I have need of you. There are creatures that must die.
He likes that. Okay. Oh, wait.
I'm gone.
Hold on. I want to go that way. This huge clock looks like it's been partially melted into the black stone surrounding it, but the ground around it has been disturbed as if someone walked on it recently, perhaps in the last few years. It's funny how we get to do all this and the shadows just wait. There is something crudely scratched on the clock face and you suddenly feel a strange crawling sensation worming its way through the back of your skull. You know what's written on the clock is a message to you from you. Writing. The message carved on the clock face looks like it was carved with a dagger. Run. Doors are lies. Use cannons, then portal. It looks like the message was written in some haste. Following the message is a crude arrow pointing in the opposite direction as the long hand on the clock. That way. Thanks for the advice. So I guess we're supposed to go this way? Oh, that's one of them. The ancient machine looks like a forgotten war relic. Most of the machine is covered in dust except for the strange panel with levers at the front of it. We've read this before, I believe, last episode. Oddly enough, the ground around the panel is disturbed as if someone walked there recently, perhaps in the last few years. The panel is a series of gears and levers. Beneath each one are a series of scratch marks that look like they were hastily carved there with a dagger. Some bear no marks, others bear a single slash beneath them, and one has an X. Without knowing why, you know the X lever will somehow help you leave this place. Pull the lever mark with the X. It gives way easily beneath your touch, to your surprise disintegrates into mist and spreads to your hand, which also begins to fade, then your arm, then you are overcome with dizziness and the walls are fading out around you. What? This is one of those interludes. Oh, we didn't see her.
It's difficult to separate shadow from the darkness here.
Okay, we didn't see him go against Fall from Grace. I don't think this is going to end well either. I actually wonder where she is in relation to the Nameless One at this point.
Ah, the Tanari.
So, you are the spider that lies in the center of it all. I have many questions that you could answer. Your goals in this matter have not been entirely clear. My goals are not for you to know, Fallen Tanari. My indulgence is all that keeps your black heart beating in your chest. You may leave with your life now, if you will. He'd let her live? My heart is neither black, nor do I fear for my life. My companions, my friends, are here in your fortress. Shall not leave until we are rejoined and the man we follow has resolved this matter to a satisfactory conclusion. There is no satisfactory conclusion to this fool's errand. You will leave this place and you shall leave your undying companion here. Fear not for his life. The only price he shall pay is the loss of memory. As gracious as your offer is, I must refuse your offer to abandon my friends. As for the small price he will pay at your hands, it is the equivalent of death to him. I have traveled with this man for some time, and there are many things I do not wish him to forget. He will forget. It is his fate to remain ignorant. He will forget you, Tanari, just as he has forgotten all who have walked the path of misery with him. He exists to die, forget, and die again. He is nothing. That is your judgment. The fact remains that I do not wish him to forget me, nor all that he has struggled for him to reach this place. He has suffered much, and I find my sympathies lie with him rather than the arrogant creature who postures before me and fights as a coward fights, preferring to kill from a distance where his opponent cannot reach him. Shall torment him no more. Tanari. Perhaps you doubt my powers here, in this place. A demonstration may silence your doubt.
You have done nothing harm. Prepare yourself.
You are nothing. I can forge planes with my power. I can unmake you.
We can't control this battle, we can only destroy it. We feel rather helpless. Not good. Oh boy. Make it down these stairs? Can I move? Here's another one. Where am I going? Okay, Anna, this one we've seen. I'll read it again though. Anna breathes on her palms and rubs them together.
Ah, the fiendling girl.
Where is the one who brought you here? I think this is a shorter reading. In a place where you'll never find him. If you think to be taking him, you'll be needing to get through me first. Your words have passion, strength, and precious little reason. If it gives me the strength to gut you, I do not care. Curious. Your reason for following him here is becoming clear. Enough of your chattering. If it's a fight you want, then... Could it be that you somehow perceive yourself as special in his eyes? If you're going to try and get past me, then go on and do it. Fiendling, I have watched the one you follow across many lifetimes. I know his heart, and I know there have been countless others who have felt passion for him. Of them all, you are certainly the least. You are a thing, bastardized by your parents and the planes. Shut your bone box, you hear me? Shut. Answer me this, and you will know silence, child. Does the one you follow matter to you?
He matters more to me.
Then die.
Okay, Transcendent was wrong here, at least this time. Is this the last we're seeing of these characters? That will be it. I have to watch them all die? Can they be brought back somehow? Alright, okay, I have a general idea of where some of these are. I wonder if we can make it past this shadow. Okay. Oh boy. I think I have to go this way. Of course, there's more. Holy crap! Let's see if we can just get rid of some of them. A lot of them. We're stuck. The game's stuck. Yeah, we're dead in the water. Well, that stinks. I was just about to hit. Was I supposed to hit that thing? Alright, not happy here. Game crashed. Okay, let's try it from here. I'm gonna start my timer again. Maybe there was just too many of them on the screen at once. Of course, there's some gonna waste spells here. Okay, now I gotta start taking some of these. Like water. Come on, Cloud Kill. Okay, I guess Cloud Kill's not going to start going. I'm not sure what's going on here either. Is it because are they sapping his strength or something as well?
Die.
I remember hitting them. So just take this thing. Since they're gone, can we save? We could save, okay. Alright. This way. Two cannons done. So if the game crashes again, or if we die. Take one more. Should we save it?
This is it.
Yes, it is.
Done. Gone.
I'm just trying to get over here.
Done. I'm gone. All right.
I think he might be able to go this way, but... The only thing I could just hope to get a cloud kill off, I guess. Casting it. Okay, is this not going to happen? Or is it just... I guess they interrupted it. If I could get rid of one. Interesting how they're not connecting right now.
I'm carrying too much to move.
Oh, now he's carrying too much. Yeah, how does that happen? I have to drop everything? I can drop everything.
Too much to move.
This capacity is going back up.
Down.
I guess they're sapping his strength. Wait, let me look. Strength is 4. Huh. Damage I'm doing to it. I'm not. Okay, now I'm getting hit. Yeah, when they hit you, they sap your strength. I get it. Anything happening here?
All right.
I guess they're just interrupting all his spells. We should have a little message that shows up, you know. The Nameless One's spell has been interrupted.
I'm carrying too much to move.
No kidding. Alright, let's try one of these. Actually, no, I have to go out. Okay, when's his turn? Things like candy here. Only he could move somewhere. I wish you were gone. I think we have to go over here somewhere. It's just, I'm stuck. I can't move. I can't do anything. Get rid of it? I think I did.
Done.
Alright, I'm out. Oh, there's more over here.
I'm carrying too much to move.
Oh my god, now he can't move again. This is impossible, guys. as I hate to do it.
All right.
There's a... It's just...
All right.
I'm pretty sure it's on this level. Is it this? Oh, okay. I thought it was farther away for some reason. The Khan.
Shadows.
I've been saying Gisarai correctly all this time. I'm proud of myself.
Submit.
I may be bested in battle, but I shall never be defeated.
You cannot hope to defeat me.
I have been here before. This time I shall never leave.
So be it.
Oh boy. Don't see anything here, so I'm pretty sure I have to go down these stairs.
All right.
Let's run this way. That way. Oh, God.
All right.
I'm supposed to go up there. Chip trying to head me off. Is that it? Huh. You quickly find the X marked lever and pull it. It gives way easily beneath your touch and disintegrates into mist. You take a deep breath, but unlike the other times, nothing happens.
Dated my journal.
In a distance, you hear a roaring sound as if something just opened, and a howling wind is rushing through the vaults. As you try and figure out where the sound is coming from, you suddenly realize you are disintegrating and becoming part of the wind. Okay, as long as it takes me away from these things. Now what's happening? I want to save the game.
Processing.
Yeah, Noradam. Poor Noradam.
Plane. Negative material. Location. Fortress of Regrets.
Yeah, you better be Fortress of Regrets.
Ah, the rogue construct.
Sense of closure imminent.
Oh boy. I feel bad for him.
You have overstepped yourself. Submit.
You wish harm upon one who has aided Nordum at cost to his selves. Nordum will attempt to stop you.
No, Nordum, just run.
Prospect of success. Slide.
Yeah, if even that.
The body is a shell. Intense pressure may fracture it. Shall I continue?
That's one way to put it.
You intend to harm him, Nordum will stop you.
Oh boy. Now we can't save, right? Oh, not even because enemies are present, just the game cannot be saved at this time. So where's this portal? Survival point? don't see anything here, so I guess we're going back down the stairs. Where's this portal? Well, that's the problem. I don't know where the portal is. Oh, it's back there. I was right there and it teleported me away. I gotta run all the way back through. It's anticipating my movements. There's no way. Let's try Cloud Kill. I don't know if it's the right thing to do. It's gonna be on me, right?
I'm hurt.
No kidding. Another one.
Ugh. I'm gone. I'm gone.
Too many. Holy crap, man.
All right.
Ugh. I'm right here.
I'm hurt.
I made it. Here comes Ignis. Save? Oh, thank God. I'm telling you, not enjoying that part of the game. Okay. I hope I'm past the shadows.
This is it.
Yeah, this is it. Okay, guys.
The skies shall be flames, and all life shall be as torches.
Right. Okay. Well, we're pretty much, until we move, at least, nothing's happening. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Tune back in when we see what the hell's going on here. I guess, I don't know. I guess we're going up against Ignis. Looks like he's coming. Cinematic. See you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.
The skies shall be free.